Blackstone presents Hurt You by Marie Myung-Ok Lee. This book is read by Jolene Kim. All the goodness and the heroisms will rise up again, then be cut down again and rise up. It isn't that the evil thing wins, it never will, but that it doesn't die. John Steinbeck. Prologue. March 23, 2019. Sunnyvale, California. AP National. A stranger attack inside a cost-cut chain store Thursday caused chaos. A Sunnyvale High student managed to draw his gun and subdue his attacker, a man with a prior history of mental illness. Disability advocates clash with gun rights activists as the state legislature passed one of the broadest Good Samaritan with a gun laws in the nation. This is the clearest case of freedom to self-defend and help others without worry of repercussion, said Mervyn Toller, former state senator and now head of the Firearm Freedom Forum, a gun advocacy group. This tragic example comes as if timed by God to show us exactly how stand your ground and Good Samaritan with a gun laws are supposed to work. It's not homicide. The child saved his own life. Floyd Gunn of the State Police Union agrees. Citizens need to be able to defend themselves, especially these days, as we can't always be there, everywhere. This brave young man kept the attacker, who was many times his size, under control so others could escape. Gun restrictors would just have the civilian populace be helpless in the face of these threats, added Toller. That's why I left a secure seat in the state Senate so I could devote myself fully to this issue. Georgia Kim wakes up the way she wakes up every day since the incident. First, she emerges from the mists of sleep, thinks of her brother, wonders if he slept okay, worries briefly about Suds, then realizes he is gone, sudden unexpected death syndrome, or any other way for him to die suddenly, is gone, too, because it's already happened. The world dims. Feeling as if she has weights shackled to her limbs, she reaches over and taps her open laptop. She scans the news and the internet for stories, as if the right story, a national gun ban maybe, might bring Leo back to life. There's still the magnet sticker for Leo's lucky rabbit's wallets stuck to her laptop's cover. She will not remove it. She makes sure to get up a half hour earlier than the family so she can do the scan quickly, silently. Else her mother will start worrying about her burning out. Her mother doesn't know that fighting for Leo's legacy is what's keeping her alive. The news makes it sound like Leo was a combination of Godzilla and King Kong. Sure, he could be rough, ungentle. She had once shown him a bumblebee napping in a flower, fluffy, peaceful, adorable. And before she could do anything, he'd reached over, crushed the entire flower, bee and all, in his fist, then howled when he got stung. He might have even struck her too. That's how he reacted to pain. It was confusing to him where it came from. His nerves were like a railroad that was all jumbled up. That was his condition. See, besides being her brother, he was also a human with a neurological condition that affected every cell of his body. This disease, this thing made him huge while also making him developmentally delayed, as if it was just a temporary matter of a train being late. Nope, that condition was also who he was. The bigness and the handicap of cognition. He could barely speak, but he also never lied. And he loved many things. Georgia has gone on so many forums to type over and over and over with exclamation points that people with intellectual disabilities, even though often seen as scary by the public.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.